Counter-Strike Season 5, and hit the downloads page. You can get that right now. And right before the game goes live, quick shout out to the GXL for hosting us, or will be hosting us for the LAN finals. Really soon, coming up really, really soon. And, you know, I thought for sure I'd be seeing iBuyPower there about an hour or so ago. But
definitely,
you know, maybe if they don't exactly recover from their trip to Europe, maybe we won't. Who knows? But this game is already underway. Take it away, Luca.
So this will be first round of our triple header now, our double header for Vex Gaming Esports. Well, actually, not a double header for Vex. They didn't get to play the first game against Make War Not Love. But we're seeing them now, Vex Gaming Esports versus Area 51, also a nuke match here. So we just came off of a very, very exciting nuke match. And hopefully let's keep this rolling here with Vex Gaming Esports versus Area 51. Hopefully this can continue with some exciting matches tonight. And so far into the pistol round, tons of damage taken from Area 51. Let's quickly talk about who we got playing here. Alex is in instead of Mo. No Mo. You guys will not be seeing that tonight. Arya with two picks already, though. Dropping down lower. There's Fox answering, though. Taking down Nozwall. Let's see if Fox can get another one. Wrapping his way through the control side. Takes down Disciple. So it's going to be a 2v3. Arya with that big 2k on the round. Fox with a 2k of his own. Trying to fight Arya at the back of the bomb site. Arya does win that battle. Jaynor is going to drop down into the vent. He's going to continue to try and push Alex. Can Alex make it happen with the 3-shot? And he does. So that's going to be a 2k for Alex. A 3k for Arya on the other side of things. Fox with a 2k of his own. And Area 51 does pick up the first round on T-side Nuke.
Are we going to be in for another long double overtime game? Is that what's in store for us? The Area 51 picking up this early round?
We might
Who
see
knows?
That.
Who knows?
That would be exciting.
I have an 8 a.m. tomorrow, so I'm going to be very not excited when I sleep for about 4 hours. But either way, forget it. First day of class, that doesn't even count. Show up, take your syllabus, leave. Please don't show this VOD to my mom. But yeah, no, I mean, Area 51 did a really solid job of getting down to that lower bomb site, winning all the engagements that they needed to. Just really, I don't know, it seems like these T-side teams have been, or these teams have been kind of flexing on their T-sides of Nuke. It was something that we saw even in the European ESL tournament earlier a few weeks ago. We saw NiP versus Cloud9, where Cloud9 absolutely dominated on their T-side of Nuke. So really, I don't even know what to believe or what to feel anymore. It definitely is still ridiculously CT side of it. These CT or these T teams are really making a push for it, and that's what I like to see. Right now, Area 51 creeping their way into the lower bomb site.
Yeah, definitely. Let's see if they can keep this going here. Area 51 with that one round advantage. Outside is going to be Fox. He gets the headshot on Disciple, so that's going to give the one player advantage here to Vex Gaming Esports. Can they keep this going? Ooh, Nozwall. Ooh, he's out of it now. That shot there, that's a 2K so far for Fox with the scout. He's going to keep pushing. He's going to try and grab another one. Mameen from down below, he's going to get this flank off. Let's see if he gets the right player. He's going to go for Nitro. Not able to get the kill, though. Does a ton of damage. He's going to back out. He is getting hunted right now by a Pro 90. So let's see if he can get out of there. Pro 90 over to the top. Is he going to get the kills on him? No, Natu is able to take down Nitro. Natu is able to get a second one, and only one terrorist left alive. That is going to be Arya. Snap over to his perspective, trying to get the flank off. Red will turn around and remove his face for him. Big 2K for Natu, and Vex is able to win that eco round against Area 51.
Huge 2K from Natu. Natu was a really big threat in the last Dust 2 game that we saw from them, picking up a bunch of frags with the CZ, and they won a lot of eco rounds on that Dust 2 game, right? Like, I think two on their T side, so they are a very eco-friendly team, I guess. That's, I don't know if, whatever. That sounds weird in terms of environmentalism, but whatever. They're a very eco-friendly team. They like to win ecos. Natu was able to throw it together with the CZ right there, and here we go. The outside pressure is on, as Area 51 is throwing themselves at the outer players, one of which has a scout.
Let's see if they can keep this train rolling here. Nitro goes down to Fox. That scout so far on Fox has been completely deadly, able to get some kills off on Nitros. And there is Natu, able to get another kill on an Oswald. So now we have two players down from T-side. Area 51, Vex Gaming is looking to try and grab this second round, but right there is going to be a terrorist in his face. Arya is not able to capitalize, and Fox will take him out of it. There goes Alex at the end of it. Red with an M4 on Disciple. So Vex Gaming is up by one round now. No, in small part thanks to Fox with a 3K because of that scout.
Yeah, dominating outside, not allowing Area 51 to get any of the traction they needed. Interesting not having Mo in the game, as he was Area 51's absolute and scariest op threat. So we're going to be seeing Arya picking up the slack where an absent Mo is leaving, I guess. I guess you can't, if he's absent, you can't leave the slack. But either way, he's going to be picking up the op for them. Let's see if he can do anything about recontrolling outside. As Fox is actually holding on to that scout, so kind of questionable going up against ops, but yeah, I don't know if that was even Mameen and Jaynor opted to hold on to their Galil, so I think they thought they did more economic damage to Area 51 than really they did. So Area 51 is in a huge position to take this round.
Definitely. Oh, Alex gets taken down through the floor of the catwalk outside. That's going to be Natu, who's able to take him down. So Vex Gaming with the early player advantage here. Alex is out of the way, and that's going to be 5-4. Vex looking to capitalize. Once again, this will be a full buy, but Arya even things out. Takes Fox out of the round, so it's going to be 4-4 now. Nitro trying to peek the window in the hut. Let's see if he can get a pick for his team. Oh, Nozwal is going to be the one who drops out, or Lawson, however you'd like to say that. He takes Red out of the way. Natu drops in and trades Lawson out now. And now we have Nitro. He's going to be in the smoke. Can he get Jaynor? Yes, he does. So Nitro is able to take down Jaynor. Nitro on the trade. Mameen on the flake. Takes down Disciple. So it's going to be 2-1. Arya is left alive here with the op. And can he make something happen? Let's snap to his perspective. 1-2. Bomb down towards the lobby side of Hut. He's going to throw a smoke, cover his exit. He grabs the bomb, only 10 seconds. He will be able to plant off this unless the spray comes from behind. Here they come. They're going to rush him. Spray does happen. Not before he gets the bomb planted, though. Natu will end up cleaning up the round and a big 4K for himself. Vex Gaming will be up when this is over 3-1.
Yeah, Natu continues to be a threat. Once again, just like he was really early on in that Dust 2 game. In the Dust 2 game, I guess he's just a really fast starter, as he did cool off a little bit in the Dust 2 game. He couldn't keep up the super high damage and frag rate that he was putting up early on, but it seems to be that a hallmark of Natu's play is that he comes on strong very early. So if he can keep it up, I guess Vex Gaming will be in a solid position to continue to win rounds, especially as Area 51 is being forced on a save. I think you caught that first pick that Natu had through the floor on the guy that was creeping to heaven, or excuse me, yes, to secret. That was a really nice shot. That was a really well-placed shot, just a few taps to the head, timed perfectly. Natu can really be a threat.
This will be round number 5 going live here. Vex Gaming Esports versus Area 51. Let's see who's able to cash in. Mameen is able to get 2 right off the bat before Arya is eventually able to trade him out. Arya goes down, and that is going to close out the round there. That's going to be 4-1 in favor of Vex.
I'm not even sure what kind of game I'm supposed to be seeing at this point. There was a second there where I was like, wow, Area 51 just can't put it together. I can't believe they can't do it on T-side nuke, which is like the craziest thing ever. It's always been a really CT-sided map. So after watching iBuyPower and SKDC duke it out, really trading really solid T-side halves, it has skewed my my perspective on what is going on in this game. Area 51 right back in it with the gunplay. Have a chance to win a few more rounds here. I now have to re-temper my expectations.
Definitely. Let's see if Area 51 can grab a few more rounds. They're going to try and drop down. Lawson is going to get caught in the smoke, not able to get his way down the vent. He was definitely trying to go for it, but two terrorists have made their way in the connector. Red takes them both down. One more to beat. That's going to be Alex. There he goes. Arya is left alone in the upper bomb site now. Red is all over the top of him. Red ends up getting it, and that is going to be an ace for Red as the terrorist with guns tried to take the upper bomb site.
When iBuyPower was doing that same split that Area 51 just attempted, one of the reasons why it was so successful was Dazed coming through the mini garage got 1 or 2 kills pretty much every time. I'm not sure what a lot of it could be, a combination of timing, game sense, smokes and flashes that they were using, but every time he came through mini, he was getting a jumping Galil frag or spamming a guy through the vents. And that round, Area 51, well, I mean, they gave Red the ace, who was playing behind the vent, got cut that, had all of their players cut down from that one position. So if they're going to make that wrap happen, they need those mini guys, the first ones out, to be a little more effective, and they need to hunt that frag, even if that means losing a guy in the process. They can't be scared of that trade. And Fox hitting a sick wallbang headshot to take out Arya really early on, who seems slightly unable to control outside.
This will be round number 7 now. Vex Gaming has a little bit of a lead here. 4 rounds. It is CT side, though. Area 51 definitely needs to win some more. And Disciple is going to put the team on his back with that running one tap on Fox. Lawson is able to take down Red. So it will be a 4 versus 3 here in favor of Area 51. Disciple's got a kill. Lawson has a kill of his own. And now Fox is the only player on CT side to get a kill. Natu is in a good position to take down Lawson. Sees him. Is able to get it off. And Lawson not able to make that quick twitch one tap there of his own. Mameen in the vent is about to face off against Disciple. Mameen wins the battle. It's going to be a 3 versus 2 in favor of Vex Gaming. Now a 3 versus 1. Only one player left alive. That is going to be Alex. Let's snap over to his perspective as he's working by himself 1v3. He does have the bomb. He is lower. They don't quite know where he is yet, but I do believe Mameen is going to be the fast rotator. Bomb is going to go down. How does Mameen... Okay, there Mameen goes. I'm surprised he actually didn't hear that plant noise. So Alex is there waiting at the vents. That flash will not get him, actually. It runs right past him. So Mameen's going to peek anyways, though. Who can get the frag out? Alex gets Mameen. Quickly traded out by Natu, though. And that will be another round for Vex Gaming Esports. As they get this defuse, it'll be 6-1.
Yeah, vertical sound is really a problem with this game. And it's really... exaggerated, or it's much worse on this map than really any other map, because there's no other map where one bomb site is on the other one, right? It's pretty much only Nuke, and the way that Nuke is set up. There's times where I will be lower and just instantly rotate upper after hearing a bomb plant, you know, being 100% confident that the bomb is one place. So the fact that Mameen got slowed down a little bit was not the end of the world. He was still there at the end of the day to support his team. Area 51 continuing to buy up as they have lost the last 6 rounds in a row. So they're accruing full bonus money, and they're going to be looking to stop the momentum of Vex Gaming. Vex Gaming looks pretty solid right now. Fox has been controlling outside with the AWP really effectively. Red and it was Mameen who actually came up through the vents last round to be controlling the mini area really well. And we haven't really seen a huge loss of ramp since pistol round. So good on Vex Gaming.
What we're going to see there outside, that's going to be Fox, who's able to take down Nitro on the Red Rock, and it looks like your terrorists are going to try and execute inside. Alex gets one. Once again, Red over in that corner grabs 2 big frags before he gets traded out. So 2 versus 1 now. Aria, we're on his perspective. He's the last terrorist left alive. Mameen is right there on the ladder in the smoke. He's going to throw a bad flashbang, and he's not going to peek off that, but they know for a fact Aria is ready and waiting for that. Mameen makes some noise. Fox is right there waiting. Aria might have the right idea here. If Aria hits this vent and does this correctly, he doesn't make any sound. Oh, he shot the vent out, though. He's going to wait, though. He's going to wait on the sound, see if Fox rotates hard on him. Mameen will get the peek off, though, and get the flank, but Fox is too fast with the op. Takes him down. Big 2K for Red. Big 2K for Fox. That is going to be 7-1 in favor of Vex Gaming Esports.
Even with that shot out vent, he really had an opportunity to continue to sell that fake. One of the vents in the upper area was already open and the other one wasn't. So I think that the Vex Gaming players, once the vent was shot out, they just assumed it was that upper vent when Mameen saw that he couldn't see where the one player was, but he saw that one vent was open. Maybe as like a fake that the terrorists would shoot the vent but still stay in sight and get the fake, but either way, he came right back up the vent to re-challenge, I guess assuming that his fake would not have been sold. But I think had he waited a little bit on it and committed to the fake a little bit more, he might have had it.
And Disciple's going to be fast into the ramp room there. Mameen was all over it. Fox also taking down Lawson. Nitro is in hell right now, trying to get the kill off on Fox. Fox is going to get the peek. Not do enough damage. Take him down to 10 HP. Nitro will eventually get the kill. Mameen is going to push now. Gets taken down from the P250 of Alex. So it will be 3-on-3 here. Alex with a kill. Nitro with a kill. No CTs alive right now. Currently have a kill in this round. So it will be 3-on-3. And Nitro very, very low. Down to 10 HP, actually. Aria, full HP. Aria is going to get a kill off on Nitro. Almost got that kill right there. He turned around, wasn't quite able to put down enough damage. So it'll be 2 versus 3. Aria is going to jump into the vent, but Nitro comes out through the hut. Now Jaynor, last one left. He does have a player in the vent that he's going to try and beat. Alex is going to peek out. Can't get the kill on him, but Nitro peeks out with the pistol one more time to get another kill. Nitro with the 3K to secure a second round for Area 51 on T-side Nuke.
finally breaking the streak of Vex Gaming. That was, what, 7 rounds in a row for Vex Gaming? So Area 51 definitely due for a round win. They sold that fake really well as Jaynor and one more player who was with them in the area were totally faked out. They were looking towards the vents and the mini area. And when the play happened outside of Hut A in the upper bomb site and they got shot in the back, they were completely in the wrong position. So smart play by Area 51, staying elusive for as long as they do. Let's see if Fox can get this pick with the auto sniper, and he does. I think he's been 3 for 3 with those picks, and Jaynor pushing into the lobby, getting another one.
That is going to be huge for Vex. Two are opening picks here. Nitro is up on the Red Rock, though. He's going to try and drop down, and he's going to get sniffed out by Nitro, or Natu right there. Excuse me. I'm butchering these guys' names together. Lawson does get a pick of his own outside. Taking down Red. Here comes the auto sniper. He saw Lawson cross, I do believe so.
I think, but the there's nothing he can do.
Smoke. Oh, it doesn't matter. The smoke clears. He is able to take down Fox. So only one player left alive. That is going to be Disciple. Can Disciple get one more? He does take Natu out of it. Fox does get a 2K, and no one is sold on this yet. Fox is right there. Auto Sniper wins the battle versus the AK, and Vex Gaming takes an 8th round. Score will be 8-2, Vex Gaming Esports.
Yes, not only have they locked up the half-winning round, which is huge and a big sigh of relief, but they also have kind of put Area 51 in a position where their economy is all over the place. They have Nitro, who was pretty loaded, had about 7K, and the rest of his teammates not so loaded. But luckily, unfortunately, he did use that money to buy up his teammates, so it is going to be a full buy round for Area 51. 2 Galils on Disciple and Nosewall, and 3 AKs on the rest of the players. Fox has really been a threat to them outside and just has been locking it down pretty much all game, just not allowing them to get any traction outside, whether it was with an AWP or with an auto sniper. Just really not allowing them to get any traction. So good on Fox for locking down that entire part of the map. I mean, that's a huge strategy for a lot of teams to work outside, and if you can't do that, that's like one of 3 things you can do on this map.
Let's see if they continue to keep this going here. Mameen, with an interesting flash there. I guess it worked. I don't think he was trying to do that. But Vex Gaming Esports is up 8-2 currently. And now we're going to have all the terrorists stacked up right now. Looks like they're going to go for the upper take. Here comes the flash and smokes. It will upper take. They're going to execute out. Alex goes down. Lawson is able to get one. Fox is able to get Alex. And Natu gets traded out right there. So Nitro, the rest of his teammates are in upper. Will be 3 versus 3 now as Jaynor gets a kill. Arya's going to peek around the corner. Arya goes down to Jaynor also, and Vex Gaming demandingly taking this round here. That's going to be Jaynor with a 2K, Fox with a 2K. Score at the end of this will be 9-2 in favor of Vex Gaming Esports, but they are CT side here. So Area 51 does have a good chance when this side switches.
Yeah, they do, but they do need to start picking up rounds sooner rather than later. I mean, once again, my perspective and my demand from these teams has absolutely been skewed by that iBuyPower game that we just witnessed, where both teams had pretty good T side. So I know that's not realistic to ask for every time, but anyway, back to the strat. Jaynor was in a super clutch position, lurking behind smokes by that box inside for so long. Yes, the 2K health, but really, it was all about the positioning that he had, where even though he let the bomb go down, he was in a position where he could take so many players out of the game and out of the round that even the remaining players weren't exactly in great position. So really smart play by him, staying hidden as long as he could.
This will be a whole loss. Wow, that was an accident. Caught by that fire. That is unfortunate there. Mameen still down lower. He gets one before traded out here. This will be an eco attempt from Area 51. They have earned their way at least to the ramp room. That nade is going to do some damage there. That fire is going to set Alex back a little bit. Oh, trying to drop down into the dark spot is going to be Disciple, who gets taken down by Fox. So now we have Alex and Arya versus 4 alive CTs on Vex Gaming. Fox will peek out with the auto sniper. If he stays up in the control windows, I think he's in a better position right now. Doesn't really matter. Now Arya is already down into position at the lower part of the bomb site. Alex is going to be their last one to try and rotate down there, so it'll be 2 versus 4 here. They're going to work their way slowly down into the lower bomb site. Alex is going to check that. There goes the smoke. Alex will go down and try and plant in the smoke. He will get the plant off in the smoke. Fox is going to be the fast rotate. Arya on the flank, though. Arya's in a good position here. He's going to go out with a scout. Fox is completely blind. He's going to drop back into the vent. Janor will take him down. So now they know exactly where the last player is. They know he's in the toxic. They're going to nade those doors down, drop a fire on top of him. He's forced to peek. He gets one. Doesn't matter. Red is all over the bomb, and we'll get that. That's going to be a team ace there for Vex. Each player got a kill of their own. Red comes off the bomb, has enough time, gets it close, though. I do believe he did it for Notch. He was trying to find a different gun. Yeah, there he goes. He picks up the auto sniper now.
Yeah, smart play. I mean, that's one thing that you don't see a lot of pugs and pug players do, because mostly because they don't think about it, because the communication isn't as important in those game types. But I mean, recovering guns is super important, especially really expensive guns like the auto sniper. So they knew they had time to kill on the bomb timer by waiting on the defuse and not defusing it immediately. It allows his teammates, or I think it was what, Mamin on the bomb, or whoever was on the bomb, allows his teammates to give, who was then now to, even more time to find a gun, get their economy right, you know, keep holding on to the guns that are helping them be successful. So that's a small trick that it's really, it seems very common sense, but I think you'd be surprised how many people haven't really even considered that. They just kind of go instantly for the defuse.
Yeah, let's see what's going to happen here. Vex Gaming Esports does have a commanding lead now. They are on CT side. It's 10-2. Area 51 would definitely like to pick up these remaining rounds to try and make this a 10-5 half. That would set them up nicely as they go to switch sides. But Vex Gaming is just, they're strangleholding the CT side so well right now. They're set up good. They're not making too many aggressive plays, not getting careless with their lives in this round. They're already up a player. Fox is down to 29 HP, though, but the AZK on Fox right now is working very, very well. And speaking of the AZK, we haven't really
seen... That's what he was missing.
Yeah, the
AZK.
That's
what he was missing last game, clearly.
It was the AZK. We haven't seen AZK use the AZK in quite a while, I feel like.
I need to rename it.
It might have to lose... No longer called the AZK anymore. We'll wait to see who's going to hold it down. But Janor and Mamin both getting headshots with their respective M4 versions. And now Mamin's going to drop down lower. There goes Alex. Disciple goes down to Nachu. They did get a bomb plant, but Vex Gaming will take this round on the defuse. That will be 11-2. Vex Gaming is up commandingly.
Yeah, at this point, Area 51 is going to need to lock up these last two rounds. Or else I think Vex Gaming is going to give them some trouble on their T side. I think the cushion that Vex Gaming has is enough for them to work with. And they, as you said before, are not a very risky team. They don't like to take a lot of risks. Or it's not that they don't like to. It's just they seemingly don't need to, because they play a very controlled style where they're always trading. They're always rotating off of each other, positioning each other in such a way that they don't need crazy individual play. So if that's the case, I think their skills will translate over pretty well to Nuke. But we'll have to see on that one. This round, it is guns up across the board. Fox pushed up with that auto sniper. Might be able to put together some frags here, catching Disciple off guard.
If he's able to make this happen here, this could be huge for Vex trying to win another round. Natu, doesn't matter, gets one of his own. And there's Fox finally getting a kill with that auto sniper this round, or outside this round anyways. He's been getting plenty with the auto sniper. Red takes down Lawson, but that was going to be a trade out. Fox has dropped the auto sniper outside. Arya is right there trying to shoot through the hut. It will be 4-2 in favor of Vex Gaming Esports. Bomb is still dropped outside of the lobby. And Red, spraying through the hut side, is able to take down Arya. So only one player left alive on the T side, Area 51. That's going to be Alex. He does have an... let's see if he can make this happen. He gets heard right there with that scope sound. They know where he is now. Runs away, makes a bunch of noise. Above him, it's going to be Natu, though. 2K for Natu, 2K for Red. And Vex Gaming Esports has made this a 12-2. So at least they will win this half 12-3 if they lose this round.
Yeah, Area 51 is going to be fully buying up this round, but they really don't have a lot of money to work with. They're going to be really getting by the skin of their teeth, even a scout on Arya. Don't think that's what they need to control Fox outside, who was actually taking a bit of a risk last round, which is, you know, I thought a little aggressive of them, but clearly it paid off. So if you use that controlled playstyle and, you know, take some risks here or there, I think teams begin to not suspect it. So well played from them right there. Even Red getting that full spray down through hut was awesome.
Mamin is playing so well until he just got taken down right there. Alex was able to take him down. He's going to push once again. Able to take down Natu. And Area 51 trying to make this a 12-3. Doing what they can. Jaynor, last one left alive. 1v4 battle here. Alex with a 2K. Arya with a 2K of his own. And Jaynor's going to peek. Disciple can't get the battle done. And that will be a third round for Area 51. But Vex Gaming is able to take 12 on their CT side. Let's see what Area 51 can do on theirs.
A really successful CT side from Vex. I fear that Area 51 is also lacking that Opta that I was talking about earlier, missing Mo. Arya picked up a scope gun a few times, and the only round he was successful, interestingly enough, was this last round where he had a scout and managed to catch Fox off guard as he was...
You still there?
Right, it's a...
Oh, lag. Big time lag, sorry.
Question?
Yeah.
Is it you or me?
My game didn't lag, so I don't know what happened there, but you cut out for a second. Now we have robot voice. I can't hear you at all. You still there?
I'm still there. Can you hear me?
Oh, now I can hear you.
Okay.
We're having a little bit of drop issue right now, currently in this call, so hopefully things have sorted themselves out. I don't know if you guys can hear him. I can't hear him, but, Are we back later? No, we have no later currently. So what we're going to see here is we're going to be getting ready to go into second half. Vex Gaming Esports versus Area 51. And let me check and make sure it's not on my end. Connection problems. No, I'm good everywhere else. So it's the connection between you and me that we're having problems with later. Hopefully you're back by now. But can't hear you yet. So we're still having issues there. But we're still waiting for second half to go live here. Vex Gaming Esports versus Area 51. Vex Gaming Esports with a dominant CT side. It was 12-3. It's not uncommon to see that CT side on Nuke. It's definitely a lot easier to play. It's definitely a CT-sided map. So Area 51 is going to have their bid at trying to win as many rounds, if not more, than what Vex took home when they were on CT side here. But Vex Gaming does have the commanding lead, so this pistol round, once again, is going to be so unbelievably important here. If Vex can get this pistol round done for themselves, that will be huge. That will give them at least one more round, put them into the 13th round, and then it will force Area 51 in trying to win eco rounds against them, which CT side with the CZ-75... Not so bad. Not a very hard eco round to have to win for yourself. But it does put the pressure on you to try and continue to win in rounds to not allow the other team to move themselves. If Vex does get that first round, that'll put them at 13. Area 51 will be trying to prevent the 14th round and the 15th round from happening unless they can win one of those eco rounds or the initial pistol. So they definitely want to try and win this on CT side. And I'm curious to see what Vex is going to bring to the table on their T side. And let's go find out if we've got later still. You here yet, later?
Can you hear me?
I can hear you now. Nope, connection problems have reaffirmed themselves. So let's do this. I'm going to drop this for a second. I'm going to recall you while we're waiting for this to go live and see what we can have happen here. So we have completely... I hear you again now. Are you okay?
Can you hear me?
Yes, now I can. It keeps saying that you're going offline and then back online.
What?
I can hear you solidly now, as long as you're going to stay in this.
Am I still lagging?
You're lagging pretty bad. It's pretty bad. It's all right, though. We still have plenty of time. We're still waiting for players to ready up here. We're actually only waiting on Arya. I'm assuming he's taking a short little break here, getting ready for this. And we are all readied up. Arya has just readied up. So second half is about to go live here. Vex Gaming Esports versus Area 51. Vex Gaming took 12 rounds on their CT side. Area 51 only 3 on their T side. So the roles have switched here. And this is going to be a pivotal pistol round here for Vex. Actually pivotal for both teams. Area 51 really needs to win this to prevent Vex Gaming from getting that early 13 rounds, and Vex really wants to get this to try and bring this home against Area 51. And I think you've completely dropped later, haven't you? We have completely lost Later. So we're going to be doing this solo for a minute until I can get him back in here. So this will be round number one underway for the second half of this game. And Red opens up the round early, push in to the A bomb site. They're going to get one kill. Ooh, Arya strafing across is able to get the headshot off on Fox. So it's 4-on-4 now. Almost close to 4-on-3. Two players are already up in heaven. That smoke is going to help protect those terrorists or those CTs a little bit now. And Jaynor is going to be trying to watch that connector. Already pushed out. He's going to be lost and gets one. Can he get any more? Jaynor is going to be shooting. Natu is also fighting. It's going to be a 2v3 now. Jaynor very, very low, down to 7 HP. He's the last hope. Not much time left on the timer. He's got to get out and get this. Prevent the plant. Yes, he does. He prevents the defuse from happening. No time left on the scoreboard. Nitro is going to try and stick it anyways. Arya is going to run away and survive that round. But that round does go to Vex Gaming Esports. Score will be 13-3. And that was just an absolute storm into the upper bomb site. Do we have you back later? We have no later back yet. He is still dropped completely out of this. But that was an absolute storm fest that we saw from Vex Gaming Esports just barging their way into the upper bomb site, kind of preventing the retake. They ended up only having one player left, 1v2 situation. Jaynor did what he needed to not allow that defuse to happen. It was really close, though. Partial blind just spraying, ended up getting the kill. It was very close to being a complete defuse and a round win for Area 51. But they did what they needed to prevent that. Arya outside with a scout, with the jumping scout, actually taking a page out of the playbook of, I believe that was Fox on the other side. And actually, Fox was the one who died to the scout right there. So we're all tied up 4-4 player-wise. Vex Gaming still with 13 rounds, Area 51 with 3 of their own, and Area 51 is forced to try and eco light by this round. There's a Swag 7 on Nitro, and there's a CZ75 on Disciple. Lawson does have an upgraded pistol, same with Alex, and your terrorists are waiting very long here. They're down to only 45 seconds to try and execute. Looks like they're going to work their way down secret. Bomb is still actually outside, just kind of hanging out on Jaynor right now. Hasn't really moved around yet. Let's see if he's going to end up going anywhere. Now he's working. It looks like they're probably going to try and come up vents and try and take the upper bomb site. He is down to about 25 seconds, and they haven't executed yet. They're going to be working their way into the vents now. Disciple will be in the hut. He's going to get some damage off. Let's see if Lawson can make something happen. No, he gets taken down. So only Alex is left alive now. Bomb is going to get planted in the upper bomb site. Alex is trying to work. That 5-7 gets one kill. There goes a smoke. That's going to partially smoke him out. He's got to try and drop down and wrap back around. And Red is going to be right there waiting for him with the AK-47. And Red brings that shot home. That will be 14-3 in favor of Vex. And Red actually with the 3K that round. So Vex Gaming is one round away from locking up 15, making it a 15-3, and putting Area 51 into a situation where they need to win every single round from here on out. If Vex gets this round, and as you
can see, hear me?
Now I can. You back?
Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off. Yeah, I guess I'm back. Woo! Someone was a little upset that I had internet there for a little bit, but it seems like I'm back. So
there we go.
May go down again. Who knows? It was really weird. I could connect to the Twitch chat. I could connect to anything except for Skype and the match. But either way, I'm back. Vex Gaming seems to be continuing to really dominate and keep the pressure up. They've won two of the two counts, but man, Darky just puts a hole in Fox.
That was a nice kill there. Quickly traded out by Mamina, though. And it's all even up 4-4 now. Nitro is going to be trying to work against Red. Who can get the shot off? Red is able to take him down with the Galil working against Nitro. CZ75 auto there. And it's going to be 4v3. Red is down to 2 HP, though, so it's really close to being a 3v3. Arya is going to be the player in the vents. He drops down in there. No, that was not Arya. Excuse me. That was actually Disciple that's dropped into the vents right now. Arya is going to be working from the ramp with the scout. Lawson goes down. Ooh, Disciple does make a good decisive trading kill. Arya is trying to get that jump scout out. Disciple goes down, so now it's going to be a 3v1. They know where the scout is. Arya still gets the shot off. He's still trying to get that jump scout. Mameen is going to run away with this bomb. He's going to try and get back into the vent. They're going to try and get out of here, but they have to worry about that scout. One player gets away. That's Mameen who gets out of there, and his teammate Red with only 2 HP now. They're going to plant that bomb, and there is Arya trying to shoot through the floor with a scout. So let's snap over to his perspective as Vex Gaming Esports looks primed to try and win this 15th round, which is going to put put Area 51 into a complete do or die here. They'll have to win every round from here on out. Flashbang comes. Arby is going to peek. He's going to be trying to work that jumping scout once again. Bombs planted in front. He should know one's probably lobby, and one should be for sure in the mini garage. He's going to peek with the scout. Makes it happen. No scope. He's just going to keep running around. He's got to try and get this kill. No time left on the score, and that is going to be Mameen who locks that round down. That's going to be a 2K for Mameen, a 2K for Aria with that scout, and Vex Gaming has locked up that 15th round. 15-3 is the scoreboard.
At this point, Vex Gaming has a really, really solid cushion, and the economy for Area 51 is not fully there. They did have some money. They're definitely going to be buying up. This is the last round. They have no reason not to, but it looks like Darky, a.k.a. Alex, what we've been calling him the entire time, only rocking a Deagle, no Swall as well, pistoled up, and that is it. Aria does have a Scout, which is an interesting prospect. Hopefully he can use that effectively once again, just like he did last round. And Nitro and Disciple both have M4, so they are not out of it, but they're certainly at a massive disadvantage, especially since it seems like Vex Gaming has had their number pretty much all game, both in the shooting category and just overall strategy, communication, teamwork. Vex Gaming has really been on point and throwing it together when they need to. Aria, man, hitting a great scout headshot on Jaynor.
That is really going to open up the round there. Jaynor is out of the way now, so Aria has done his job with the scout so far. Let's hope they can keep this going. Hopefully they can. Aria is very low now, down to 37 HP. That is going to be an execute here from the T's. Mameen is down into the control side of lower with the bomb and a teammate. That's going to be Fox over there. Still upper is going to be Red and his teammate Natu. There goes Fox. So he's down at control side. Natu and Red still upper, causing a little noise. Mameen goes down right there. Area 51 trying to bring it together on this buy round or their buy out round. And Disciple does it with a big 2K for his team. Staying alive, but Area 51 in the complete danger zone now. They are forced to win out every single round. They can't lose a single one. Otherwise, that'll be a game for Vex Gaming Esports.
Yeah, that's going to be, I think, really tough for them to do. But at least this round, Vex Esports is going to be giving them a gimme as they save. Really, it was all about Disciple shutting down that that inner rush, taking down one guy that was in the squeaky door is what I'm trying to say, the squeaky door area, and then transition that into just general upper control, not allowing any of the Vex players through that door, through any of the doors, locking down the entire upper bomb set. Solid round win from them, despite the fact that they had a firepower disadvantage, and I mean, I'm sure not happy with getting knifed in the back. Luckily, it was a left click.
Oh, the knife. Aria is able to get a scout kill outside. Jumping scout working for him. Disciple gets an M4 kill. There's Nitro taking down Mameen. And Red on the trade out gets lost and out of the way. Nitro shuts it down, though. Alex or Darky is able to get Jaynor. So Area 51 is still alive. Only terrorist to get a kill is going to be Red. The score will be 15-5. Area 51 still on that bubble.
Yeah, Vex Gaming still doesn't have exactly the amount of money that they need, and because they do have such a large 10-round cushion, they're not going to force it. They don't need to force buy right now. There's no sense in it. If they lose, they're just going to put themselves further in the economic hole, so they are totally willing to just buy Deagles and CZs and try to take the fight to Area 51 while they can. Even if it's a blunder round, won't be the end of the world. I think once they get AKs and real rifles in their hands, they'll be able to take a real crack at breaking Area 51. But it seems like Area 51 is really solid with their hold when they have rifles in their hands. So it's going to be a tough nut to crack.
They're definitely doing what they need to now after Vex Gaming has broken out to an early, early lead here. Area 51 does not want to get blown out right now. They are on CT side. This is their time to collect as many rounds as possible. And once again, guys, they are only fighting for a tie. That is all they have hopes for now. And that tie will mean they go into overtime. And if it happens, that'd be awesome. That will be our second overtime of the night. Three overtimes altogether because that iBuyPower SKDC game did go to double overtime. That would be impressive if we could get that one more time tonight.
Oh, God. Yeah, I mean, it would be extremely impressive. I'm not sure if my heart can take it, especially this, the emotional roller coaster that was this stream. And, wow, Fox hitting a really good flank and catching one of the mini players off guard. Jaynor falling victim to a different guy.
Oh, the 1D from Red. Not enough, though. Aria takes Natu down. Nitro on the trade out. Big 2K from Nitro. That's going to be 15-6. Area 51 still has a lot of life and the economy, but here comes the buy from Vex Gaming.
Yeah, at this point, they're going to be, or they being Area 51, is going to be completely buying up every round. There's no reason for them not to. Aria is going to hold on to that AWP, but Noswall going to in, or actually he's going to be dropped it, but is going to grab an auto sniper for himself. I wonder which way he's going to go with that. He's actually going to be going outside, so where is Arya going to bring that off? He's going to be pushing ramp with it, getting an aggressive angle, so he's going to be getting a lot of intel. I wonder if he just saw Mamine cross there, but no, he did unfortunately shoot a little too early, revealing that he is there, and I think the terrorists would be silly to re-peek him at this point. Especially one more time. I mean, come on, you're alive. Run away with your life. Take it.
Mamine is a very aggressive player, and he makes it work for himself, though. It's aggressive, but it's smart at the same time. It's kind of a weird play style that we see.
He's definitely Vex Gaming's wild card.
Yes.
He's capable of anything at all times, and you never know when you're going to see crazy Mamine. But when he puts it together, he definitely puts it together.
There's Lawson outside with the AZK, working it so well for his team now. He gets the opening pick of the game, or of the round, excuse me. Natu goes down, so it's going to be a disadvantage for Vex Gaming Esports. 4v5 this round. And Area 51 trying to keep this locked down. If they can keep this going here, that's going to help them so much. They could be forcing Vex Gaming back into a save. Red does even it up a little bit there. There goes Fox. He's able to get a kill of his own. Can this fire get off in time? Oh, does not do enough right there. Alex and his teammates just shut it down. Nitros with a big 2K. Darky with a 2K of his own. Lawson with the other kill. And Area 51 has got this a little bit closer now. 15-7, Vex Gaming. And if you're Vex Gaming, you're one more round. That's all we need.
Right, yeah. It's super important for them to keep their composure at this point. They do have such a lead that they don't need to fall into that just one more. They're not making the comeback. They've already at least secured overtime. So, I mean, that is a massive amount of comfortability. Like, they're saving this round. It's not going to be a big deal. Obviously, they want to win. Obviously, they're trying to win every round. But losing these Eco rounds is not the end of the world to them. They have plenty of gun round opportunity where they are going to be able to attempt to best Area 51. And Darky has really been turning it up this half in particular.
Darky finally gets traded out right there. That's Mamine with the CZ-75 auto who gets the headshot on him. They're going to execute their way into the ramp room. And Jaynor with a huge play to take down Arya. And that's going to be an op in his hands. But Red is down to 9. Jaynor is down to 10. Mamine down to 24. Doesn't matter though. Natu gets a nice pick on Nitro. Disciple takes down Red. So it's going to be 3v2. They're very low onto the round though. They have the bomb lower. Lawson on the flank with the AZK. Makes it a 2v2. Spraying through the door a little bit here. The other CT is in the vents already. They have one gun. If they can get a pick on Lawson, that will be huge for them. Disciple makes his presence known. Lawson peeks out. Lawson gets taken down. Natu now has to try and get this peek and not get naded out. He is at 100 HP. He does have a 2K. 1v1 here. 23 seconds on the round. He makes some noise. He's going to wrap back around. Now Disciple has to be worried about where is Natu. Does he have the bomb? He has picked the bomb up. He's going to plant lower. Let's see if Disciple bites on it. Disciple does not come out the right vent. He's going to come out the left. 1v1. This is going to be a huge clutch. Natu goes for the op peek. Can't make it happen. Disciple will get the kill and the defuse. Vex Gaming that close. 1v1 to winning that game. Defuse comes from Area 51. That will be a score of 15-8 as the round ends.
If Natu put together that op shot, that would have been a real BDP, as Anders likes to say. It would have been a really huge peek to both lock up the game and make a sick op peek. All the players on Vex Gaming this round had upwards of like 6K for the most part. The only one who's close to broke right now is Fox, and that's only because he has an op in his hands. The gun rounds at this point going forward are just going to be rolling out of Vex Gaming. They're getting maximum bonus money. They already stockpiled a bunch of money because they saved a bunch of time. This is where they really get to put on the pressure of Area 51. And it's one thing for Area 51 to, you know, beat them and then survive an eco and then, you know, maybe a second eco if they're lucky and then try to beat them with guns again. But that's one thing. They get some breathers in between. Now it's just going to be all pressure all the time unless Area 51 can really do some lasting economic damage, like stay alive all 5 rounds and, you know, make sure they get kills every time. Don't let anyone escape with any guns.
Let's see if they can keep this going here. We're going to see Fox up on top of the Red Rock right now. He's going to be rocking that op. And there's actually an AZ, or excuse me, yeah, there's an AZK out there and an op on the other side of things. Arya's got the op. AZK is going to be on Lawson. They know Fox is up there on Red Rock. Can Fox get the op shot off? No. Arya is able to take him down. So already one player is down from Vex Gaming Esports, and Area 51 is looking very, very good on their CT side right now. They're going to actually be pushing. Nitro is right there to help out Lawson. Lawson gets flashed by his own teammate. He's going to have to back up. And then Darky is downstairs as the terrorists have officially taken the ramp room now. Here comes the push. They're going to drop down. Nitro's right there. He peeks out. Red takes him out of the game. It's all tied up now. 4v4. Lawson makes it 4v3. Arya makes it 4v2. And I hit a bit of lag right there as the bomb's going to go down. We lose Natu. So now only Mameen is left alive. And he's just going to run into the smoke with a bomb. He's got no time left on the scoreboard. Can he get it before he gets killed? No, not able to. Disciple spraying through the smoke will get the headshot on him. That's a 2K for Arya. And Area 51 is staying alive in this, trying to force that overtime.
Clawing their way back into it. That was a good play by Mameen, running into the smoke like that. Obviously, it didn't pay off. But with 5 seconds left on the clock, he was planting the bomb in the smoke. His two options were... either I get killed planting the bomb, the round's over, no harm, no foul. I, you know, go back to spawn with like 800,000. That would be crazy. 8,000 K, which is redundant, in the bank.
8,000.
Wow, that's a loud card. Yeah, I'm really. It's so hot in my room, and we've been doing this for a long time. But either way, what's my woes? We can worry about those later. Jumping into the smoke, he was either going to get the bomb plant down and then die after time, and that would have been cool, would have held on to all of his money, or, as I said, would have died with the bomb plant, which did happen, so he did end up escaping with his money and didn't get tricked into getting killed after time.
Oh, that's going to be Lawson outside. 1, 2, 3. Rack him up for him. Jaynor, last player left alive. He's going to be in the lobby side of Hut right now. He's going to try and see if he can make a pick happen. This is going to be 1v4. He gets pushed. He gets spotted. Darky knows where he is. Disciple knows where he is. Push incoming. Lawson with the 3K outside is going to bring this within 5 rounds now. 15-10. Area 51 is catching up.
Yeah, they're catching up. I'm sure their Vex Gaming is now feeling... the pressure. They've let a few too many rounds slip through their fingers, but they still have the money. They are buying up now for the third round in a row. This is their third gun round in a row. That's pretty crazy. I have to imagine that it's a numbers game. They were so easily able to pick up... I guess it was only the first round. It was just the pistol rounds. But they were, at least on CT side, so easily to pick up necessary rounds that I'm shocked they're getting shut down. But here we go with the upper take.
They're trying to do what they can. Mameen gets one before he gets traded out. CT's all over the top of it, though. That's going to be a 2K for Disciple, a 2K for Lawson. And Area 51 is within 4 rounds now of forcing overtime.
Wow, and Vex Gaming is continuing to buy up. They've been getting shut down pretty much everywhere since they won the initial pistol round. They had some success getting to the lower bomb site and trying to defend it, but... really, they haven't been successful with guns anywhere. There hasn't been, unless I'm just forgetting, I don't think there's been there was that now 2 round in the lower bomb site. Yeah, lower is totally where they should be heading. It's where they've had the most success. Disciple has been an absolute killer from the rafters, and Nitro has been playing well with him.
Ooh.
And man, Arya now taking control of outer, doing now what he was missing. On his T side. That spam upper is not going to be close to Disciple, but I wanted it to be. Thought it was close.
So Vex Gaming has already lost a player early into this round. That is going to be Arya, who makes the op shot. Absolutely just relieves Red, who was up on top of Red Rock. So now the manned advantage will go to Area 51, who is primed to try and grab a 12th round and prevent Vex Gaming once again from getting that 16th round that they need. And we're going to push that much closer to the overtime. And, Arya once again, op shot through the squeaky from Big Garage, makes it happen, flashbang from Nitro. The other three terrorists are set up for upper, and it doesn't matter as Nitro is able to take down Natu. 2K so far for Arya. Disciple gets on the scoreboard this round with a kill. Mameen is just going to execute to try and make something happen here. He's low. Lawson takes him down. That will be 15 now to, excuse me, when the end of this round is over, 12. In favor of Vex, but Area 51, they only need 3 more rounds. and
yeah,
we're tied up.
Only three more rounds, and Vex Gaming is saving. So if they could just survive this round and give it to them again on their next gun round, they might be able to make this comeback
happen.
They're
going to force overtime.
Yeah, I don't even know what I'm looking at this point. My brain cannot comprehend the nuke that we're watching tonight. The nuke has done this
upper.
To us before. It's an upper take. I'm not exactly sure why they're so interested in upper.
Disciple's able to drop out of there and get out of there. Eventually gets taken down. Nitro, though, on the cleanup crew. Nitro with the 3K to shut it down. Disciple with two of his own. And Area 51 is one round closer. There's only going to be two more rounds left in this. If Area 51 can win this, that is going to put them really, really close. Only one round away from that overtime.
I think if they can survive this gun round, they will be absolutely close enough to make the overtime happen. Vex Gaming seems really interested in the upper bombsite, which surprises me because I don't think they found any success in the upper bombsite. I don't think they've even gotten a bomb planted in the upper bombsite since they've had guns in their hands this game. The closest rounds that they've had were them going to the lower bombsite, and still they're grouping up in lobby trying to find those picks, waiting for an opening to take upper. I'm a little confused by it. I'm not sure if Secret is the right play because I wouldn't want to challenge Aria right now, especially since they have all rifles and no scopes, but a ramp play might be the right play, but no, they're going for upper once again.
Going for upper again. Nitro is in the prime position to grab one. Can he grab any more? He's going to get pushed again. Mameen goes down right there. Natu on the trade out. There's Disciple. Lawson gets it. Aria is able to shut down Janor. We are now within one round of having another game go to overtime, and the economy is a little bit hurting for Vex Gaming, but they're terrorists, so it's cheap here. Now Area 51 is going to fully buy out. They're going to have pistols. They're going to have all the nades. They'll have head armor and every gun that they could ever want in their hands. They're going to go for it. They're going to try and get this and force this overtime.
Yeah, I'm not going to beg, per se, but, you know, maybe it's about time that Vex Gaming attempts to go to ramp, because I've been asking for it for a while. There's a chance that they're scared of Lawson's auto sniper, which is actually definitely a threat that I kind of lost track of. I pointed out earlier when he bought it, but I feel like we haven't really... It's been all about Aria getting the op frags outside. So I could definitely see why they want to avoid that, but, you know, smoke and flash them. They haven't had success anywhere else. You gotta go back to what was working at some point.
Area 51 has come back and absolutely made a game of this here. We thought they were just going to get wiped out by Vex. Vex was able to grab that 15th round, and then that final 16th round has avoided them. Oh, that's a good fire right there. That is a well-placed fire to prevent that rush into the ramp room. That's going to hold them off for a little bit longer. That's going to force the issue a little bit here. That's going to let time tick down a little bit lower and put the hurt a little bit more on Vex Gaming. Area 51 just has to hold on, and they will force this overtime. Look at this rotate over towards ramp, and it looks like Vex is setting up for upper one more time. They're going to try and ring it out. They're going to go for upper again. They think they can get it. Only 25 seconds are going to be left on the clock. Here comes the execute. No time for gunfights at all. They have to get in there, get this bomb down, and defend. Let's see if they can make it happen. Disciple's going to take Red out of the game. He's going to get taken down, though. Nitro is able to get a kill. That's going to be another one for Lawson. Oh, my goodness. We are going to see overtime here. Not too last one left. He goes down. Another overtime tonight as Area 51 ties it up. Overtime. This is our third round of overtime that we will see here. So technically, overtime number three.
I think I'm gonna die. I think this is just too much Counter-Strike for, or too much emotional Counter-Strike for one man to handle, or in this case, two men. High five for sticking it out on such a late and crazy night of games. I don't even know what we're viewing anymore. Vex Gaming had absolutely no response for Area 51 when they had guns in their hands. I mean, how many rounds in a row do we see them lose in the upper bombsite? Like four, five? Every gun round? I think every gun round.
I don't think they took a single round in upper on their at all. The gun rounds,
I don't think,
or
they even got a bomb plant. Yeah, I don't. I'm confused as to why they continue to put the pressure on upper when they haven't been able to find the success there. I don't know. Maybe they see something that I'm not. Maybe they're scared of the scopes that are outside and towards ramp, so they just would rather try to go rifle to rifle. But either way, it just hasn't worked. I mean, that was their most successful upper take, you know, right off the bat, because they were able to take down Disciple before he killed like three of the terrorists in the process. So hopefully, for their sake, Vex Gaming gets themselves right. I think either a quick ramp take with a smoke towards the CTJ or throwing a bunch of smokes outside and trying to get down secret and trying to get past Aria with that op might be the right play here. I mean, even if it's not the right play, or even if that's still going to be really tough, it's not like they're finding success in upper. So if they don't mix it up soon, they're just going to be just more one-note play that Area 51 is going to shut down every time.
Definitely. And for those who are rejoining us right now, the reason why that you guys leave and you come back and it's 15-15 is because you left. You don't ever leave SIVO TV. This is where it's at.
This is what you miss.
It's always happening. You leave, you come back, you're in overtime. You don't want to miss this stuff, guys. There's no reason to leave us.
Especially on Nuke. I don't think we've had one boring Nuke game.
No, we never. SIVO TV, we have some blowouts, but 90% of our games are absolute grinders. It's ridiculous. You guys remember that triple overtime with iBuyPower and Cole? Yeah, that was us. We bring
that
home.
Was on season, wasn't it?
Yeah, triple overtime on season. Yeah.
Do you remember the triple overtime between Netcode Guides and Manajuma that we casted where Shroud had that crazy
the
super
Shroud with the ace? Yeah.
There's, I think that was the last time we casted Nuke, right?
No, we did it the other day. We casted some Nuke the other day.
If we don't include the last time we casted Nuke, we've been all about the overtime on Nuke. So this is where it is. If you want overtime, if you're hungry for raw emotional Counter-Strike, this is the place to be. Wait for SIVO's Nuke week, because that's where things really start to pop off.
Definitely.
Hopefully these teams will ready up soon. It looks like that one player is missing from Area 51, and we will be underway ASAP. I'm sweating a lot out here, so I'm sure Vex Gaming sweating just as much as I am, as they're in a much more pressure-filled situation.
Oh, goodness. I'm excited, man. We always have the good games on here. It's ridiculous. Hopefully, you guys enjoy this while we're waiting. Once again, huge, huge shout-out to our partners, CSGO Lounge, for providing all the betting that you guys get to do on these overtime games, these nail-biters that we get to watch, these triple overtimes, double overtimes, 1v5 aces that we get to watch happen here, 1v5 clutch aces, nonetheless. We hope you guys enjoy that, and big thanks to CSGO Lounge, also Game Servers, for providing the servers you guys to play on, and last but not least, definitely not least, Alt Pug for providing the client you guys get to play on, and also the free Pug service that you guys get to join with us, partnered with us, brought it through with SIVO, so hopefully you guys get to get on there and enjoy that as much as possible. I know I do all the time. Hopefully we get to see a lot of you guys, and then also GXL, where SIVO LAN will be hosted in Philadelphia in October. Hopefully we get to meet a lot of you guys out there, and hopefully you guys get to come watch a lot of these games in person. We're going to get to see these best North American teams tee off on each other, and if we get overtimes on LAN, the hype is going to be unreal.
Yeah, even if it's air conditioned, I might still start sweating in there.
Oh, man. But it looks like we are finally into the first round of overtime number one, Vex Gaming Esports versus Area 51, 15-15 right now. This overtime is happening. Area 51 does get CT side first, so they need to try and keep this momentum going here. They played a completely shut down defense so far. Yeah, that's a shutdown defense, yes. It works. Don't worry about it. But they played the shutdown D, and it's worked out for them so far on CT side. Let's see if they can keep this going here. We haven't talked Preds all night long, except for when we talked about iBuyPower versus SKDC. Who's bringing this home? And it will be first overtime or second overtime or third?
Oh, God, please don't say third. I mean, I really don't know. It really depends. If Vex Esports is willing to switch up their strategy, they're already moving towards ramp and they have a pick, so clearly they're finding instant success here. Thank God.
Oh, Mameen opens the round up. He gets a frag right there, and that is going to be helpful. Only two players left on CT side. Let's see if they can keep this going. Only one left alive. Vex Gaming finally puts it together on T side. Nuke Janor with the 2K of his own, and that's going to be Vex with the one round advantage in overtime number one.
Now, I'm not here to throw around I told you so's. That is not in the job description. But I might have to write it in because I told you so. They went ramp and they won a round. Like, how hard is that? They were finding success there pretty much every time, and they just shot their way right through a hole, taking down the two biggest threats right off the bat. I mean, the two players in J is what they feared during during regulation time, and they just iced those two guys right off the bat and cruised their way to a round win. But instead, they wasted so much of regulation time just kind of sitting in lobby and not winning any rounds. So I guess now that they're adapting, that's really big. Man, Nozwall's gonna eat that grenade.
Oh, that will be Nozwall going down. Red is able to take him down, so Vex Gaming has already got that one-man advantage. Nitro is gonna be the player that drops into the vent. Terrorists are already down lower. Natu is right there. Gunfight ensues. Who's gonna win this? It's gonna go to Nitro, so it's gonna be tied up 4-4 now. There is Fox right there in the window. Area 51 doing what they can. Nitro gets the flank. And taken down eventually. Red is down to 26. Mamiyan is down to 25. Here comes the rotate from the CTs. It'll be a 3-2 on the retake. Red has to get that shot. Can't make it happen. They know the last player is in Toxic. One player blows it open. They're going to be all over Mamiyan. He's going to try and cross over. He gets taken down by Darky. Here comes the defuse. Aria is on that. And Aria is the player without a kit. That's going to cut the timer kind of close. But it doesn't actually matter. Aria will get it defused. And we're tied up once again. Vex Gaming Esports versus Area 51. Overtime number one. Both teams have won a round so far. Last round of this first half.
Now, I wouldn't say I told you so is in the job description. But I'm going to have to keep writing in because they continue to find success in the lower bomb site. I'm just so shocked that they spent so much time losing and losing and losing when it was all seemingly unnecessary. I mean, they didn't win that last round, but that was the best lost round they've had since pistol round of that half. Right, exactly. They got a plan. They were, you know, making a play. I mean, had a chance there. I think Area 51 is now keying into this and playing a slightly more aggressive ramp play, but one round is solid enough on overtime of T-side, so if they can lock up this second one, it's just going to be icing on the cake for them to lock it up on CT's side, but or at least based on what we saw from their CT side earlier.
And Vex is going into the upper bomb side. Aria is going to get flanked right there. He rushes directly into the back of that. Lawson gets one before the trade-out happens. A Darky, last one left. He should get sprayed down right here. Mamiyan actually doesn't go for it. 1-2. They know exactly where Darky is. Darky knows where Fox is. He sees his gun. What is he doing? I thought he saw his gun. Doesn't matter. Gets the shot off. He's going to throw the flashbang into his face. Doesn't matter. Mamiyan gets it off. And that is the first successful time Vex Gaming Esports has taken the upper bomb site and won a round. So they won two first half. Area 51 has won one, so Vex only needs to win two. Area 51 has to try and win out here to try and get this win.
Yeah, that's going to be a tough one for Area 51, I think. And the reason, one of the reasons why that upper take was so successful, not only were their nades well placed and they were shooting well, they got all the frags they needed to pretty much instantly. They were never in any danger to be fully shut down, but because the previous rounds they had gone ramp and gone to the lower B bomb site, they had set that precedent. They showed that they could potentially go all over the map. So the players that were upper weren't just sitting there waiting. When are they going to come upper? When are they going to come upper? They weren't sure which way Vex Gaming was going to go. And I think that little bit of trickery, the trickery in using both bomb sites, caught the Area 51 players that were up there a little bit off guard. And that, in tandem with the solid play, helped Vex Gaming pick that up. So Vex Gaming, just what, two rounds away from locking this up and bringing home another win?
Bringing home that bacon. That's where they need to be at right now. They're going to try and do it as fast as they can here. But Area 51, I think they might have learned a little bit from their first T-side, and I don't think they're going to let what happened to them initially happen again. But the advantage is in the hands of Vex Gaming. Now on CT side, they had arguably the better CT side initially, even though Area 51 did lock it down really, really hard to make that an overtime. So they did the same, but it looked like Vex was just a little bit tighter on their CT side. So let's see if Area 51 can keep this momentum rolling here, or if Vex is actually going to hold on to this and eventually squeak out the overtime win, or if we get overtime too.
Yeah, I think in the first half, it was Vex Gaming was really doing a solid job of shutting down Area 51, whereas in the half where Area 51 was on their CT side, it was more like Vex Gaming just throwing rounds away and just, oh my god. Can you hear me still?
Oh, yeah, we're there. We're still with you.
Okay, cool. Sorry, I'm starting to get that lag again. Someone is really annoyed at my existence. But either way, we're gonna fight through it. Yeah, it seemed like Vex Gaming was really actively trying to throw away their T side. So I think this is going to be a close one. I think Vex Gaming has what it takes to sew it up right now. But really, I mean, Area 51 shocked us once already.
Yeah, definitely. Let's see if they can do it this first round of second half. We'll be really telling here. Vex gets two kills initially. Are you able to get the trade out? That's going to be Fox who takes down Nitros, though. So the early advantage will go to Vex Gaming Esports. Can Area 51 keep it going? Arya goes down right there. So now only Lawson left alive. He dropped down the vents. He got lower. He got the bomb plant. This will be 1v4 here on this defend. He's going to try and work his way through the door. He takes down Natu. Quickly traded out by Fox. And that will be another round for Vex Gaming Esports. So the pressure now is completely on Area 51. Vex is on the bubble from here on out for the rest of this overtime half, which is only two rounds. Vex only needs one more. They win the game in overtime number one. Let's see if they can keep it going.
Yeah, that round, Fox continued to put the pressure on with the auto sniper, picking up a 2K. That was a big staple of why they were so successful in the first half, was Fox's scoped play. So if he can keep that up and really just cut off one-third of the map and have trust in his teammates that they can make the holes necessary and ramp an upper, I think Vex Gaming might have a chance to lock this up. Wow, Arya of Area 51 actually picked him somehow. I don't even know where that happened. Oh, there he is, by Red Rock.
He was able to make that shot.
Where was he? That's Nitro, Arya. That's over there. Where was Arya?
Arya was actually, that shot was through the squeaky door, I believe. I wasn't on it when it happened.
No way, really?
I think it was.
Awesome. That's an awesome shot.
I think it was through the squeaky door. Yeah, I believe it was. He's still trying to shoot through there right now to try and make something happen. But the player advantage is going to Area 51 right now. It is going to be 5-4. Ooh, now it's 4-on-4 as Red evens it out a little bit. Gets a little aggressive there. Ooh, there goes Arya. Vex is primed to try and win this. If he can get Disciple, they're in good shape. They do get Disciple. It's going to be a 3v2, but very, very low. Oh, Lawson makes that shot happen right there. So now Jaynor and his teammate Red are versus Nitros and Lawson. Lawson with a 2K, and they definitely have the health advantage right now. Lawson, ooh, dude, no, not anymore. Lawson ran directly into his own fire, which is not where he wanted to be. That actually put him down to 39 HP. Can he get the kill? He does. He takes down Jaynor. That is a bit into the lower bomb site. Area 51 might be able to win this round and keep their hopes alive. And Red is going to drop down. He's just going to spray wildly. He takes down Lawson. He actually gets it, but it doesn't matter. Nitro is able to complete the kill. And that is going to bring this to last round of overtime. Number one here, Area 51. If they win this, they move on to overtime number two. If Vex wins this, they win the game.
Yeah, Lawson stepping up huge with that 3K. Almost killed himself in his own fire, as you mentioned, but he was in a great position sitting in the vents, to take down Jaynor. Jaynor was the real threat that round for Vex, having 100 HP and taking him down right off the bat and not sustaining any damage in return was huge. So Area 51 continuing to hold on by the skin of their teeth, and I can feel the lag. Can you still hear me?
Yeah, you're still good.
Okay, cool. I don't know. As soon as, if I hear more than 3 seconds of silence from you and my game freezes for like half a second, I just assume it's over. But no, I'm still here, so take it away.
So this will be the last round of overtime number one here. No picks have happened already. Area 51 needs to come up big. They need to get this round to force that overtime number two and stay alive in this. Vex Gaming only needs this round, and they win the game tonight. It's going to be tight. I wonder if we will see that overtime. That flash kind of halted that. That smoke will definitely halt it. They're going to have to rush into... Oh, it doesn't matter. They actually got out of there basically scot-free, except for Fox right around the corner. Can Nitro get the kill? No, not before he gets taken down. Lawson is going to have to do the trade-out duty right there. So it's going to be 4v3 here. Area 51 really needs to come up huge to get some early frags on this take into the B bomb site to try and get their way in there. Ooh, that fire does not quite land land on Mameen, but he uses the smoke well. Red takes down Arya, so it's Disciple and Lawson. Disciple takes down Mameen. Can he keep the train going? That flashbang lands in his face. Lawson takes that down. It's going to be a 2v2 battle now. Now it's a 2v1 all up to Lawson. Lawson gets taken down, and that is going to do it. Vex Gaming Esports will win on Nuke in the first round of